Hello everyone, welcome to MipraTech. Today in this section we are going to study about an important machine learning algorithm, that is K-means clustering. So these are the concepts we are going to see in this section. First we are going to study about what is clustering, then what is K-means clustering, what is the mathematical background of K-means clustering, and what are the different applications of K-means clustering. First we'll see what is clustering. Clustering, you can tell it is a group, a small group of people or things, anything. It is nothing but a groups. So clustering analysis is an unsupervised machine learning method. It is unsupervised because we don't know what is the final output in well advanced in clustering technique. Just we are going to group or cluster the output, but we don't know what is the really what is the output. Like in supervised classification, I told we can get output as a spam or not. In well advanced, we know what is the output in that cases. But in clustering analysis, we don't know what is the our output in well advanced or what is the cluster in well advanced. So it is called unsupervised machine learning purpose. Here, the clustering determines the intrinsic grouping among the unlabeled data present. Like here, we unsupervised means we are going to give the input as unlabeled data only. Based on the given input, it is just going to give us the clustered outputs. So clustering analysis has been emerging research which in data mining due to variety of aspects, because clustering can be used in variety of applications. Like if you take an example, telecom website or any business purpose, just we are going to group the people or customers into some different groups. That is an unlabeled data only. Based on the taken various parameters, we are going to group the people. So that is an unsupervised learning. So it can be used in wide variety of applications. So let's see what is K-means clustering. K-means clustering is one important unsupervised machine learning algorithm which is mainly used for clustering purpose. What it will do means it will just divide the entire data into groups or clusters based on the sum of the similarity pattern what will observe in the data set in the training period. So it mainly what it will do, it will try to minimize the distance of the points in a cluster within the centroid. What do you mean by centroid? Means here mainly after the data has been given, we are going to plot the data based on plot. After data has been plotted, we'll take randomly some centroid, then we are going to find out the distance. So those distance has to be minimized in every step, like that we are going to cluster the input. So it is like an iterative algorithm that it will loop back. We have to do it repeatedly to get a better accuracy. Here the K means clustering. The K indicates the how many numbers of clusters we want in the output. So what is the mathematical background of K means clustering? As I told, it is an iterative procedure. Like after each input has given, the data point will be assigned to n of the k groups based on feature similarity. I told based on the similarity features, it is going to assign the given input to one of the clusters. So the K-means cluster algorithm mainly starts with initial estimates of k centroids. It's like first it will going to take a randomly some of the centroid, and then it is going to calculate the distance and mean. Again, it is going to fine-tune it the centroid in every step like an iterative way. Then it is finally it will going to get some best value of centroid. Then it is going to assign the all the input values so the as the many clusters as we defined in the k value. So the algorithm iterates between two steps. The mainly algorithm has two steps. Like first it will assign the data point, then it will update the centroid. So these two steps only iterate. It will loop back. Like we are going to repeatedly do these two steps to assign data and update the centroid to get the better accuracy. So the value of k indicates the number of clusters required. So here the k means clustering. The k indicates what are the different clusters output we want. How many? If k is equal to 2 means in the output we'll get 2 clusters. If 3 means 3. So depending on the k value, we are going to get the number of clusters. Like if we have a data set like this before k means, if we have mentioned k is equal to 3 means we are going to get 3 clusters. After the k means, we are going to name it as a cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 3. So like this, if we have a problem grouping our data, we can use k-means clustering. After the k-means clustering, we'll get our data look like this. So how k-means clustering will work? So these are the steps we are included in the k-means clustering. First, we are going to cluster the data into k groups where k is predefined. As I told, after we mention the key, how many number of clusters we want in our output, the clusters k, that many groups will be created. So after that, select a k point center random as a cluster center. First, we are going to randomly select some centroids in the given set. After that, we are going to assign the, after calculating the distance between those centroid and the given input, we are going to assign it as a nearest cluster. So here we are going, same, we are using the Euclidean distance to calculate the distance between the centroid and the given input. So after the calculate the centroid or mean of all the objects in the each cluster, again we are going to fine tune or update the cluster. So these two repeats, the step 2, 3, 4, these steps only will repeatedly do to get a final output, to finally cluster our output to get, it will look as a very accurately. So this is the formula what we will use in k-means clustering. Here the j is equal to summation of j varies from 1 to k and summation of I varies from 1 to k. It is absolute value of xi of j minus cj whole square. Here the k indicates the number of clusters what we required in the output. N indicates the number of cases, is nothing but the number of inputs what we taken in the table or a data set. Here xi indicates the case, which is the each case what we taken as the input. Here cj is nothing but a centroid for cluster j. So here we are going to, like this, we are going to predict the, calculate the distance. After that, we are going to assign it any one of the clusters after updating centroids in each step. So to get a better result, we have to choose a better k value, that is nothing but optimal number of clusters we have to choose. So to choose optimal number of clusters, we have different methods. We can use the best method, what we can use is the elbow method. Elbow method is nothing but, as the, you can see, as the number of clusters k indicates, the value total now within the sum of square also decreases. So after a certain point, it decreases gradually. Or at what point it start decreasing gradually, that point we can take it as a optimal number of k values. Here in this graph, we take a, using elbow method, k is will be taken as a 4 as the optimal number of clusters required. See, you can see in this picture that these are the, how this, the, after the data has been plotted, we, here we are divided into different cluster, cluster 1, 2, 3 like this. Here the dotted lines will indicate the data points, the black color in star what it indicates is the cluster center. So this center, the distance between the center and the, this data points only we are going to calculate in each step. And this, after calculating the distance, which distance, if you take this data as example, the distance between this, this and this, after 3 points has been calculated, and in which case we get a minimum distance, the, for that we are going to assign the data set into that cluster. So after each and after assigning every data, again we are going to calculate the mean and find out the center. Again we are going to update until we will get our required output. We are going to update the center. This is how the k-means clustering algorithm will work. So what are the applications of k-means clustering? The main objective is to find the patterns in an unlabeled data set and cluster them together. As I told, first we have to find the pattern among the given data set, then we are going to assign the unlabeled or a given input to any one of the clusters. It is mainly used for market segmentation, document clustering, for image segmentation, for image compression, customer segmentation, analyzing any trend on dynamic data, anywhere where we can group the people or things, any data. In those purposes, we can use k-means clustering. It is also used in mobile communication, medicine, economics, marketing, in human resource, the finance industry, the medical field, business. As I told, to grouping into customers, their, in a business purpose, their customers are, they are going to group or cluster them based on their some parameters. In those purposes, they can use k-means clustering algorithm. Thank you.